Congress Philippines 2020 is Miss Iloilo.
It was October 25, 2020, and I remember everything that happened on that day. It was a mix of emotions. I was very happy, but at the same time, since it's a pandemic, I didn't actually have that actual crowning moment. But I think it's a good thing also, because you don't want me to see my ugly cry. And actually, I remember when I called my mom, and my words were, "We made it together. We won the Miss Universe Philippines." It's not just Iloilo City that I'm representing, it's the whole country. And of course, there's pressure added to it. But I am very grateful and thankful to all the people who believed in me, to all the people who were there since day one, helping me with my trainings, seeing the potential in me. But I also am thankful to those people who lifted my spirit during the moments in which I feel like I wasn't good enough. I had a lot of experiences, and in a span of 1 year, I've been into different things. I've had a lot of struggles, a lot of challenges, but I can say that it made me a mature woman right now. It made me realize to be more grateful for what I have. And bad things don't last in life. I think we need to focus on those things that inspire us to be better. Everything is possible as long as you put your heart and your mind into it. And thank you so much for believing in me. I want to be remembered as somebody who gave her everything to make the Filipinos proud. I am Rubia Oxania Mateo, Miss Universe Philippines 2020.
Round of applause once again for Miss Universe Philippines 2020, Queen Rabia Mateo.
Hey, Casey, I just fell. But again, once you fell, you have to stand up.
Yes, right? It happens. It's how you recover. It's how you have to, when you succeed, you have to make mistakes, correct?
That's true.
That's right. So, Rabia, tonight is your last night as Queen Rabia Mateo of Miss Universe Philippines. And you promised that you wouldn't cry kanina. Sinabi niya sa akin.
I didn't.
I will not cry. I will not. Pero kagabi, you cried.
Yes.
So how do you feel? How do you feel coming back here tonight?
To be honest, Casey, it's a mix of emotions. I'm excited for the next girl. But also, I am getting emotional simply because I'm feeling very grateful and thankful to everybody who believed in me. And I am aware that somehow I'm gonna reach this point, that I'm gonna close the chapter.
Yes. You know, when you won the pageant, you instantly got a lot of new fans. And then when you eventually competed, you got a whole bunch of brand new fans, and I know you're going to continue to have those fans and get more fans throughout your career, whatever you decide to do. So you actually had your reign in the middle of a pandemic, right? Being on stage of Miss Universe Philippines again, what memories like are flashing back to you right now?
Probably that moment before you go out on stage. I remember I was feeling that kaba.
Yeah.
And I would remind our girls that feeling, that nervousness is normal. It just means that the competition really matters to you.
True. I mean, if you are too relaxed, you might get too comfortable, right?
Yes.
So, do you have any, let's say, messages for, I guess, the girls backstage? Do you have any advice?
To the girls, just enjoy the moment.
Yes.
If it's for you, it's gonna happen. If not, there's still a next time.
So you have Rabian addicts.
Yes.
Yes, Rabian addicts. So do you have a message for the Rabian addicts and also for the Kalbo Nation?
To all the Rabian addicts, thank you so much for making me the source of your inspiration. And Casey, I also want to take this opportunity to thank all of the Ilonggos watching right now. Madamo gid nga salamat sa tanan nga pagsuporta nyo sa akon. Madamo gid nga salamat sa pagpalangga kag pagpangamuyo nyo. And I hope, guys, I made you proud.
I know you did. Of course you did. How about a message for the Miss Universe Philippines organization?
To the Miss Universe Philippines organization, especially to Sir Jonas Gafford and Madam Shamsi Soup-Soup, thank you so much for believing in me and fighting for me. You guys made my dream come true. Salamat talaga.
How about your real-life queen, your mama? You got
my
a
mom.
Message for mama?
To my mom, who is watching right now, how I wish that you were here with us, seeing me in my last few moments as Miss Universe Philippines. Thank you so much for believing in me. When a lot of people are telling me that I am not good enough, when people were calling me different names, you were there and you were lifting my spirit. And because of that, my dreams are now achievable, and I love you so much, Mama. I promise to be a good daughter to you. Maraming salamat.
Nothing beats a mother's love, right? All right, so this is a big question. The Rabian addicts also want to know if they're going to be busy in the future. What is next for Rabia Mateo after you turn over your crown?
Well, Rabia Mateo as a beauty queen is saying goodbye for now, but I am excited to try my chances in show business. I really want to do hosting and acting soon. So hopefully to all of our supporters, to my supporters, I hope that you're still there in my next chapter.
So you would like to be hosting, do hosting?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
I'm gonna take your job.
Yep, so see ya. No, I'm just joking. So once again, ladies and gentlemen, the one and only, the beautiful, the pride of the Philippines, we have come to love you so much, and we can't wait to see what is next for Rabia Mateo. Once again, your Miss Universe Philippines 2020 Queen, Rabia Mateo.